Hi everyone, my name is Elida Neković and I'm coming from University of Birmingham. I'm a PhD student, full-time doctoral researcher at the Nanoscale Physics Research Laboratory in Birmingham, and the title of my topic is Synthesis, Processing and Morphological Properties of Highly Porous Supercritically Dried Mesoporous Silicon Nanostructures for Drug Delivery Applications. And here is the outline of my today's talk. I'm going to introduce you into the field to provide with some motivational background of this project, to show you some very exciting results, and to conclude. And let the story of porous silicon begin. Porous silicon was accidentally discovered in 1954 by Ollier in Bell's laboratories when they were trying to make an electrochemical machine that will be used with chips. Instead, so what they seen is that they were trying to dissolve the wafers completely, and that didn't happen. Instead, the voids have started to appear. The motivation of this project is that porous silicon has a highly tunable properties that can be used in a variety of applications, such as drug delivery applications, cosmetics industry, gas sensing, ultrafast dynamics, which the main one is the pump probe spectroscopy that we also have in our lab, and solar cells, and etc. In our lab, we use the double tank anodization cell in order to fabricate the membranes. We choose anodization time and the current density. Once the anodization time is completed, then we apply the high current values, which is the high pulses. And in order to completely dissolve the interface between the wafer and the film, after that, the membranes detach completely, and we use the heavily doped, boron doped silicon wafers in this case. We have achieved the highest pore volume porosity value up to date in the literature, and that was 92.3% porosity, which corresponds to 5.13 mL per gram of the pore volume. Our membranes were subjected to two types of drying. First type of drying was the air drying, and second type of drying was the supercritical drying that completely avoids the capillary forces which happen to appear in the small pore walls. We also managed to generate the porous silicon microparticles via ball milling and ultrasonication, and then to narrow the size distribution from 50 microns down to below 10 microns, and that was achieved by size select sedimentation, a very gentle procedure from 1 to 120 hours. And that was used in intravitreal injection for the needle gauge 27. Thank you for your attention.